Hi there. So today I'm going to show you guys how to turn an iPad into a reusable worksheet using one simple item. It's called a dry erase pocket sleeve. You can find them real cheap on Amazon. I found a pack of 30 for like 10 bucks. And it also, if you're a member of my class, if your parents want to send me their address to my email address, I will mail you one so you guys don't have to buy them yourselves, because it's real easy, real simple what I'm about to show you. So the first thing you need to do, if you have an iPad, is enable guided access. So
if you want to turn on guided access, you go to your settings. Once you're in your settings, you scroll here, you make sure that you are in general. So we want the general settings. And then once you got general selected, you scroll all the way down to accessibility. Once you've selected the accessibility setting from the general settings tab, you scroll all the way to the bottom and you'll see this thing right here called guided access. You want to turn that on. So I've already enabled it. So let's see how you turn it off. So basically I'll show you how to set it up. You turn it on, passcode settings. You want to set guided access passcode. I'm just going to make 00000 my guided access passcode. 00000. Okay, so now I got guided access on. Okay, once you have guided access enabled, it will stay enabled and you can use it whenever you need to use it until you turn it off from the settings tab. So if you're looking to use one of the worksheets that I've uploaded to Schoology, I'll show you how to get to that from the Schoology app. So say you want to go, so I've got the Schoology app you can download. From there, let's go to the home page. Make sure we're in my group. Where are my groups? I've been using the desktop site. This is a little different. Groups. There we go. There's my class. And I've been uploading a bunch of stuff in resources. I got a lot of stuff in the reading section right now. So let's see. We got functional reading. Let's just see what we got here. So see what we got with numbers. Okay, so as you can see, the activity loads within the app, the Schoology app, and now we got some tracing activities, some matching activities, and stuff like that. So whichever worksheet you want to use, just pick one. There's about 5 or 10 in this one. Let's just go with, that one works. Okay, now before you get your sheet protector, don't forget to turn on guided access. We're going to click 1, 2, 3, and that should turn it on. And as you can see here, I'm not able to swipe any direction. Now, if you're not able to do that when you first turn it on, you're going to have to turn that on yourself. So 1, 2, 3, put in your passcode. Now you see down here this little thing that says options. That's where you get to that. So when you first do guided access, the touch feature will still be enabled. So if you want to turn it off, when you go in it the first time, you're going to see that it's turned on, turn it off. And now when guided access is on, you can't swipe or do anything else. So now it's time to put it in to your shape protector. And now we've got a reusable worksheet. So let's just match. This is a matching. And that worksheet's done. Hopefully it will be a little easier to use. I know it seems like a lot of work to do for that, but imagine, you know, you have 15 or so math problems that and you don't have a way to print and you don't want to write them out on a whiteboard. This is an easy way to do it. And then once they're done, you know, say you want to go to another worksheet, take it out. 1, 2, 3. End it. Go to the next worksheet. 1, 2, 3. Whoops. 1, 2, 3. Turn it back on. They can't swipe again. And now you're ready to put it back in. And go to the next worksheet. Just like that. Alright, I hope that was helpful. If you guys are interested and you're a member of my class, let me know and I can get you one of these sheet protectors.